Hey everyone, Bill's back, and guess what time it is? You guessed it, it is the second most wonderful time of the year. That being the November Barnes & Noble Criterion Sale, where, if you didn't know, everything Barnes & Noble Criterion related is 50% off. A pretty good deal, one that I think they should be doing to begin with, because $40 for a Blu-ray, that's kind of sus. Anyways, I digress. If you've seen my last video, you know what the gist is. I'm going to be showing you 5 recommendations that you must own in your Criterion collection, as I do. These 5 are going to be more low-key, more underrated films. Ones that you wouldn't really figure, first and foremost, to be essential, but nonetheless, they are essential in my eyes. We're going to start this list off right away with a lighthearted one, a comedy, an English language film, and one that I think anyone can get into because it's somewhat modern. It is 1991's The Fisher King by Terry Gilliam. This is spine number 764, and if you haven't heard of Terry Gilliam, you've definitely seen Monty Python Holy Grail, so boom, now you've heard of him.
Next to Brazil, yo fucking Jimbo, yes!
He is kind of a mad lad. He's kind of insane as a director. He's made very absurd, very goofy films. And The Fisher King is among one of his best. And if I had to describe this film, I'd call it a fever dream fairy tale set in New York. So that's pretty cool, right? This film stars Robin Williams. Okay, boom, I've sold you. There you go. It's done. I mean, I'm a simple guy, personally. If Robin Williams makes me laugh and tear up in the same movie, it's a 5 out of 5. And this film's no different. Stars him and Jeff Bridges. And it's oddly kind of a dark and sad film, too. Like, it tugs on your heartstrings. And I appreciate that greatly. And this is one of the only Robin Williams films in the collection, so automatically you should check it out. If you have not, rent it if you want to not, you know, bite the bullet and buy the Criterion. But the Criterion edition is really good, really good. And I mean, if you've seen the designs, everything, it's very, very unique. And yeah, that is The Fisher King from Terry Gilliam.
Never take your eye off the ball!
Just like that, we're moving right along. This is spine number 724. All That Jazz by Bob Fosse.
It's showtime, folks.
This was made in 1979 and it stars Roy Scheider, you know, the Jaws guy. And when I first watched this film, I had really low expectations. I didn't really know what this film was about. I assumed it was about all that jazz. And, you know, it was, but it was so much more than that. It was a very deep film. It was very philosophical in a sense where it explored mortality, regret, family life over work life, and above all, it had a really powerful performance from Roy Scheider. Basically his best performance in his career. And, you know, I'm suggesting this because not only is it a very deep philosophical and oftentimes sad films, we love sad movies here, but it is a musical and it's kind of fun. It's kind of a fun movie. It's a fun ride to be on with the fam. But nonetheless, this is a beautiful movie. The opening scene alone, where there's like almost no dialogue, but just so fun and energetic, and it just shows you how chaotic his life is as a dance instructor. That's what he is. He is a director for Broadway productions, and it's a really good movie. You should check it out. And again, really sad, so be prepared, but also the songs are just great. And no, I was not done with the batshit crazy movies, because this next one is a perfect introduction to not only foreign films, but foreign horror. maybe also foreign comedy, depends on how you look at this film. This is spy number 539. This is Hozu, or House. And this is a Japanese batshit crazy movie. Big emphasis on batshit crazy. As someone once said,
this movie is like doing acid without having to do acid.
So you're okay when it's over?
It's amazing.
It is such a fun and wild ride that I can't recommend Hozu enough. Look at the cover. What the fuck is this? You know, you just look at it and it makes you want to see it. So this is a great film to show friends as well. If you want to just vibe out and just have a fun time with friends, this is a great movie to watch. It has subtitles, so you'll have to read, so maybe not be too, maybe be a little sober for it, but, you know, this film will make you feel like you're on shrooms anyway, so no need to be under any substances, but you get the point. This is Hozu. Check it out. Oh my god. Love it. The last two are also going to be foreign language films, a bit serious, so from here on out, this is spy number 519, Close Up by Abbas Kiarostami. Now, this is a Persian film made in Iran, and made in 1990, and it was my first introduction to Abbas's filmography, and I think it's a great film to start off with. It's kind of like a documentary. It's so unique. I think it's one of the most uniquely made movies. Uniquely? That's the word? I don't know. It's one of the most unique movies I've ever seen. It tells the story of a man who pretended to be a filmmaker just so he could kind of get like, kind of like a happiness booster, like a confidence booster from this family that like gave him food and showered him with love and attention. Then they find out he's not actually the filmmaker, and then he's arrested. But get this. Abbas Kiarostami heard about this story and went there, asked the guy if he could film, like, his actual courtroom hearing, like a documentary, and then when he's released, they later take this same guy and film him with the same family. The entire story of how they met and how he swindled them. It's so crazy because it feels like a movie, but it also feels like real life because it is. And it's so cool. It's so deep too and personal. It's sad, and this guy oddly gives like a really good performance. And it's just such a unique movie. I don't know. I just really like it. This is Close Up. It's Iranian, so, you know, you're gonna have to read. And it's pretty, you know, deep, so take that with what you will. Yeah, that's Close Up. Great movie. Can't recommend enough. It's this last one I'm going to recommend to you all. And this is spy number 201. This is Umberto D from Vittorio De Sica. It's an Italian film made all the way back in 1952. So it's an oldie, it's a boomer of a movie. And it's very short, you know, very concise, if that can help, you know, convince you to watch an old movie. But it's also just incredible, incredibly riveting and sad. Oh my god. If you loved Up, okay, you will love this movie. It's basically like that. This film is about an old man, and it follows after World War II, so kind of during their economic struggle, their recovery. They kind of went through a Great Depression, Italy did, because, I mean, you know, they had a pretty tough time getting help after World War II. And this just shows, like, the struggles of humans just having to just survive in this kind of environment. And it's about this old man and his dog. That's all he's got. And he just struggles day to day with rent, with food. And it's so sad, so incredibly moving, and oddly a bit hopeful. Vittorio De Sica, he likes to make movies that just really crush you. Like, Bicycle Thieves and Umberto D. They're a great double feature if you want to have some waterworks. If you want to see, like, raw humanity in films, check this out. Umberto D., one of my favorites. And, you know, it is sad, so there you go. It's a sad movie. But it's so good. It's so good. So, there we have it. Umberto D. from Vittoria De Sica. Just like that, we've done it. We've got through 5 more films you should have in your collection. As for me, what am I going to do for Barnes & Noble? I'm not sure what I'm going to get. I've recently gone through a process where I had to actually get rid of a lot of my criterions for money. A lot of personal stuff happened. I had to have surgery and bills and shit stacked up. So, and I'm all good now, if you're wondering. All recovered, all fine. Plans are going great, actually. And I will still get some criterions for the sale. Like, I'm not stupid. I'm not over my addiction. Who isn't? But I'm not going to get a ton. Perhaps you'll see a haul video in the future. Perhaps not. We'll see. But just like that, these are my recommendations to you all. And I hope you're able to get what you've wanted for the sales. Thank you all very much. Have a great day. Bye-bye.